Okay, we're back with another episode inside the 48, and today we're in Columbus, Ohio, or close to, with
Joanna McGinley.
So, Joanna, what got you into filmmaking?
Well, I've always been an actor. Mm-hmm. I think the first remembrance of wanting to be an actor was watching I Love Lucy, and I used to go, you know, be Ricky and go, "Lucy! What you doing?" And, you know, Lucy going, "Wah!" And I don't know, I always wanted to be on TV because of them. Always camera, though. Mm-hmm. I was very specific toward camera, probably because of Lucy. I never really did the theater thing.
Okay. So what primarily do you like to do as far as film? Do you like to produce, direct? I mean, what do you...
Well, I do a lot of things. Mm-hmm. My favorite thing is always going to be acting, because I'm very expressionate, as you can tell. But if I couldn't do that, what I'd want to do is assistant direct.
Okay.
I love to be that secondhand man or woman that helps out the director to mm-hmm. create their vision. I don't necessarily always have a vision, mm-hmm. so I'm good at helping create yours.
And you primarily had like an all-female team, right?
Yes. Okay. Yeah, I did executive produce an all-female team, Mindwolf in Productions. I executive produced and assistant directed. It was amazing. It was great. We were super prepared. We got it in on time. I was so proud because it was my first one producing.
Mm-hmm. How many 48s have you done so far?
I've probably just around 10, most of them acting. That was my first executive producer job.
Those were the real 48s, not like those stuck at home ones, right?
Correct. Okay. Yeah, the real ones.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, I mean, they're all real, but,
well,
you know.
Yeah. Not the fake ones.
The competitions.
Yeah. No, I did get to, during the global ones, the stuck at home mm-hmm. ones, I got to work as the camera person, which was a lot of fun. I've never done that before for the 48.
Yeah, I guess I saw you did a lot of, your whole group used to just, everybody did it from their home and then they sent it all to whoever was editing.
Yep. Yeah. We all put it in a collective Google Drive and mm-hmm. it went straight to the editor.
Cool. As far as like your team goes, do you have a specific way you do things? Do you guys like try to write everything on Friday, or do you guys actually try to film on Friday, or like what is your structure? What's your key...
I really like a lot of structure. Mm-hmm. So the week before, I am getting multiple locations in line waiting mm-hmm. to be told, "We want you Friday night." Mm-hmm. That's one of the first things I want to decide on when we get our genre, where we're going to be, mm-hmm. so that everyone's prepared that morning, Saturday. I do prefer to write Friday night and get it done Friday night. Mm-hmm. If there has to be a second draft come out Saturday morning, that's totally fine, but I want my actors to have something to know what they're coming into Saturday morning.
So you try to have it like emailed by midnight or something?
Yeah, okay. Yeah, that's the goal. Mm-hmm.
So do you participate in the kickoff? Like you go and pull it?
Or? As executive producer, I definitely did. That's just part of the fun and part of the networking.
Oh, yeah.
You know, it's a good time. Everyone sometimes... if there's a bar there, we all have a drink, you know, before we pull. It's just a good social time. Distanced. Now, distanced.
How many teams usually participate in the Columbus area?
Probably I'd say 20 to 30.
For the summer?
For the summer one.
Yeah. And you have a fall one too?
Or? We do have a fall, the haunted one, the horror one.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So it's just like Cleveland then?
Yes.
It's the same thing, okay. Mm-hmm. So that 3 weeks of terror is something completely different. It's not part of the 48?
Not part of the 48, okay. Yeah. It's just part of the Mid-Ohio Film Association. We just wanted something that was a little longer mm-hmm. So that we could hopefully produce better films. I don't know exactly what the right word for that is. Not better, but mm-hmm. more prepared.
Yeah, no, I participated in it last year. That was a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Did a lot of cool networking.
Yeah, yeah, you have a whole week to write and decide everything, a week to film, and then a week to edit, if you wanted to do it that way. Mm-hmm. You could do it so many different ways.
We just did it in 2 days.
See, exactly. Like, yeah. There's so much choices with 3 weeks.
Yeah. No, there was a lot of good ones. I actually drove back down here to see the showing, and I was pretty impressed with a lot of them.
Yeah, oh, that's awesome.
Some good talent down here.
Yeah, aw. I love Columbus.
How did you get involved with doing the stuff in Ohio. I mean, in Cleveland sometimes.
In Cleveland? So, like... so my first job up in Cleveland was an extra on Captain America 2. Mm-hmm. And I met so many amazing people on that set because they needed hundreds and hundreds of extras. So I mm-hmm. got to meet all these Cleveland filmmakers. Okay. And that's how I kind of snuck in. I joined their different groups on Facebook, you know, volunteered my time, met Conrad, volunteered my time with him, mm-hmm. met other people, met BJ through that. I think where did I meet you? I don't even...
Scales.
Was Scales the first thing we worked on?
We worked on together,
wow.
Yeah.
Wow. I feel like I've known you forever, though.
I think we've been Facebook friends for like a year before that.
Okay, yeah. Okay. We're old friends now.
Yeah. And then I think we've met in person 3 times now, I guess.
Yeah, yeah. So, yeah.
What would be some of the things that you would advise a team never to do during the 48? Like, what doesn't work? It's just never work. Don't ever try this.
It's hard to tell someone not to do something because everyone is so different and everyone's able to do different things. But I guess don't wing it.
Like, be prepared?
Yeah, be prepared. Yeah. Don't not have a script or don't not have a location, you know, like just have those easy fundamentals, you mm-hmm. know. If you have those easy fundamentals going into it, it's going to be a lot easier for everyone. If you go in unprepared, no script, no nothing, it's going to be harder. There's going to be more arguments for sure. Like even when you're prepared, there's arguments in a 48. It's just because it's so quick paced. There's no time to think.
Do you usually set aside and say, you know what, we don't, there's 5 of us here that have been directors before, but only these 2 are in charge today, so please, like, you segregate that? So
yes, everyone has their role, and they stick to it. Occasion was during my 48 for our, when I executive produced, I had an editor, and then I had a producer and a director all in the editing room, and the producer was also an editor. So they all got their, and the director had been an editor before, so they just all had this editing brain and they just started clashing mm-hmm. when it should have just been one person dealing with it mm-hmm. and like asking questions to the director, period. It should have just been a lot smaller of a group. Like it's just, everyone has their role.
Do you guys tend to edit when you're all done or do you try to edit as you go?
Edit as you go as much as possible, but if you don't have that DIT person uploading stuff, mm-hmm. It gets a lot more difficult. A lot.
And then do you have a designated sound person or do you just kind of wing it and use like the camera microphone or?
No, I definitely have a sound person. Mm-hmm. I feel like sound is a lot of the time the thing that goes wrong in a 48. Mm-hmm. It's something that's overlooked or told like, oh, I have the equipment, you can hold it, it'll be fine. It's not going to be fine. It's not.
And lighting.
Lighting. That's actually something, it was really hard for us to find a female gaffer. So female gaffers, hit me up. I was able to find female everything, but I had my DP working kind of as a gaffer as well because mm-hmm. I couldn't find someone designated for that. So hit me up, girls.
I remember I hit you up and you're like, oh, it's all female team.
I know.
I'm like, if you need makeup, like, just nope, it's female team.
I'm sorry.
Girl power.
Yeah, right? I wanted to do it. I wanted to see if we could do it and produce a film well, and it was my first one, and I'm pretty proud of it.
And I can't do them anymore now that I'm a producer, so.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Well, that's good. I mean, you get to oversee everything and kind mm-hmm. of be a part of everyone.
Yeah, it was interesting doing this last one because I doubled, tripled, and quadruple checked all the numbers because I didn't want to be wrong for the first time mm-hmm. when judging. You know?
Sure. So. That's a lot of pressure.
Stress.
Yeah. Sure.
So if you could change one thing about the 48, what would you try to change to try to make it better? You know?
Ugh, that's such a hard question. One thing to make it better. Give us one more day.
And it's not a 48.
I know. That's a really hard question. Make it better. It's such a great tool already, like such a great training tool already, that I don't know how I can make it better. I don't know how. I'd have to leave it at that. I just don't know how.
What's your favorite genre to pick?
Favorite genre to pick, definitely adventure. I like getting You've gotten that one before? Yeah, we have gotten that one before, and it's super fun. Not something that gets picked often or chosen often, but it's fun.
Which of your 48s was like an absolute disaster? You don't even want to talk about it. Have you had any of those?
Yeah. It's usually the sound that went wrong.
Mm-hmm.
It's usually the sound or lighting. Yeah. It's usually one of the two, like, oh, I don't want to show anyone that because my face looks really bad. or like, you can't hear me, so what's the point, you know?
So do you have one that you're super proud of? Like, you just...
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I really love the one that I did recently with BJ over the stuck at home ones.
The date?
The first date.
Yeah.
Yeah. It just came together so well, and I didn't expect it to. Just because we were all filming ourselves at home. It was only me and BJ, but
He's in Cleveland and you were here, so...
Exactly, yeah. And I was running all around my kitchen, and we had to be across the table from each other, and, I just hoped that everything worked out, and it did, you know? I had to redo a couple different shots to make sure that it worked, but I was able to, and we got it done, and the soundtrack's kind of funky.
Yeah, it's probably one of my favorite ones that I've seen BJ do for the Stuck at Homes.
Thanks. Yeah, it was. Yay.
Have you won any awards for any of the 48s or been nominated for?
Yeah. A few years ago when I was more doing the 48s in acting mode, I won a Cleveland Horror Best Actress, or was it Best Scream?
Scream Queen, I think.
You know, I got Scream Queen, but a couple years before that.
Okay.
Yeah, Scream Queen was because of BJ's guy. And then, and that was like last year.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So I got Scream Queen last year. And then, a couple years before, I think it was 2016. That was my biggest year. And then my kidneys happened. But anyway, 2016, I think I got either Scream Queen or Best Actress in Cleveland. Yeah.
Have you ever gone to Filmapalooza or had a team that went on to film?
No, never been on the winning team.
But I mean, just go there just to support.
Oh, no, I haven't. Yeah. No. I mean, I've been to Toronto International Film Festival, which was amazing. Not for 48 Adventures, but it's just an amazing film festival and so easy to understand and move around in that I went alone. It was just a lot of fun.
This year is the 20th anniversary for the 48, so I believe it's back in D.C.
Oh, cool.
So they're gonna, because it started in D.C. I don't know if you knew that.
I didn't.
So I believe they're doing the 20th anniversary there.
Nice.
They said originally it was supposed to be in Hollywood, and then it just sort of shifted that way. I was looking forward. I've never been to L.A. or, I mean, Hollywood itself. Yeah, but yeah.
Sure. I haven't either. I've driven all the way to Vegas, but then I turned around.
Well, that's a drive, though.
I know.
For 2 days, roughly?
It was, I think, 36 hours, something like that. Yeah.
Do you have any specific projects that you're working on currently or that are ready to come out that you want to plug or that are in festivals right now?
So I really enjoyed working on Scales, which we filmed a year ago and right now is going through the film circuit. It was supposed to premiere at the Cleveland International Festival, but because that got, pushed to the internet because of COVID, we decided to find other places to premiere it. But but it's floating around. And it's getting some good buzz, and I'm really excited for it. You were the special effects artist on there.
Yeah.
I was main actress. Scales. Check it out soon.
Robbie Barnes.
Yeah, Robbie Barnes, director.
Noni.
Yeah, Shivrick. Mm-hmm. She's awesome too, producer.
how was your experience during COVID? How was that different than normal filming?
Okay, well, during COVID, nothing happened, other than, the global and the stuck at home. So filming was just so different because I had to learn to film myself and to move the camera around and find interesting angles myself, on myself, which was hard enough too, because I would have to get the camera looking right. If you're using a phone, you have to use the back-facing camera, not the front-facing camera, so that it looks good. So I can't look at myself while I'm placing the camera. So I'd have to press it, go around, do everything, cut, and check and see if the take was okay. If it wasn't okay, I had to readjust and see if the take was okay again, and see if the take is okay again, and see if the take is okay again.
Yeah.
We worked it out, eventually. It's exhausting, but it was great. I learned how to do it.
Have you done any projects outside the 48, like, since... things are starting to open back up again?
Good question. I haven't, actually. Mm-hmm. I haven't worked on anything. I know that things are opening up, and as a talent agent, I'm starting to cast new productions. One film is actually coming to Columbus, which is very exciting. Columbus doesn't get that many feature films, so woohoo. But it seems like the doors are opening, and we'll be on sets here soon with masks and lots of...
Are they pretty strict in Columbus with the masks in restaurants and whatnot? Or?
You know, they haven't been in restaurants. I have when I go in, you know, they don't really need you to have a mask on. Some places are, like the North Market, which is a big public area where you can go to different, you know, markets and then different ethnic foods and such like that. And they definitely require masks. So it's like on a base-to-base kind of thing.
I was in Ann Arbor, Michigan last week. And you couldn't go in anywhere without a mask on.
Really?
Yeah, super strict there.
Wow. Yeah, we're not as strict. Maybe we should be, but I guess we'll find out with this second wave. I don't know.
So if people wanted to get a hold of you or see any of your work or find you on social media, do you have like the Instagrams, the Facebooks, the MySpace? And, you know, no.
I do have MySpace, but I haven't looked at it in forever, so don't find me there.
Am I on your top eight?
I'm changing that tonight. You can find me on Facebook, Joanna McGinley. You can find me on Instagram, Joanna McGinley Official. You can find me on TikTok, Joanna McGinley Official. You can find me on IMDb, Joanna McGinley. I have a website, joannamcginley.com.
Do you have a YouTube channel?
I do. I just don't I don't post on it that often. Mm-hmm. I have a couple reels on there. I link YouTube videos that I'm a part of. Mm-hmm. So you can find me, Joanna McGinley, on there.
Cool. Mm-hmm. Well, I appreciate you taking the time to talk with us today.
Of course. Anytime.
Thank you.